I'm Jim Turner, and welcome to DLife TV Online. It's going to be a great show in a new place. We'll be here Sundays at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific, with new shows about living your DLife. Every week, we'll be sharing insights, recipes from the DLife kitchen, stories about real people living and achieving with diabetes, and so much more. We're glad you're here. Now on with the show.
I'm Lynn Prowitt for DLife TV, and we are back at Palmer's Market in Darien, Connecticut today. We are going to shop the produce section, and I'm going to give you some tips for optimal health. So, I have lots to say about the produce section. This is my favorite place in the grocery store. This is where you should come and plan to spend half your time in the store right here. Take your jacket off, get comfortable. This is where you're going to expand your horizons. For example, iceberg lettuce. Are you an iceberg lettuce lover? Iceberg lettuce is great for the crunch, but unfortunately it's devoid of nutrients. What you want to do is slowly and gradually introduce more dark green lettuces into your salad. They're packed with nutrients, and gradually you'll like the taste of them too, and you can kind of ease out that nutrient empty iceberg. I want you to break the broccoli and bananas rut if you're in one. I tend to go back to the same fruits and vegetables that I know how to cook and that I love, but I want you to try something new every week, a new fruit or a new vegetable. If you don't know how to prepare something, ask somebody in your store or just Google it. And remember, eat the rainbow. Eating a variety of colors ensures that you're getting the full complement of the phytonutrients Mother Nature has to offer. So a lot of people ask me, when should I spend the extra money on organic produce and when should I not? Fortunately, the Environmental Working Group puts out a list every year they call the Dirty Dozen. And this list tells you which fruits and vegetables have the most pesticide residue on them. You'd be surprised at what tops the list. Apples, celery, bell peppers, peaches, strawberries. And keep in mind, this means after the fruits and vegetables have been washed or peeled. Experts say to rinse all produce. And this includes things with thick skins, like oranges, grapefruits, or melons. Use a brush or soak things that can't be rubbed or scrubbed. And use a salad spinner to get them dry afterward. That's a great tip. The wax on conventional cucumbers and apples and some other vegetables can be petroleum-based. So the only way to get it off is to peel them. Organic produce will only have natural waxes. To be sure, you should just ask someone at your store. Or another option, buy the pre-cut, pre-washed veggies. It costs a little more, but it ups the likelihood that your family's gonna eat it and finish it. So, what do all the things in my cart have in common? I'll tell you, they are all potassium-rich fruits and vegetables. Now, why is potassium important? It's because potassium has a relationship to sodium that most people are not aware of. I like to think of it as potassium to sodium is like oil to vinegar in a salad dressing. Bear with me. The oil softens the bite of the vinegar, and you know sodium does bad things in your body? Well, potassium offsets those bad things. So more experts these days are telling people, don't even worry so much about reducing your sodium, although that's still important, but bump up your potassium intake with beautiful fruits and vegetables like these. So, our potassium-rich cart includes these things. Dark leafy greens like spinach, kale, Swiss chard, zucchini and all summer and winter squash, avocados, mushrooms, melons like cantaloupe or even honeydew, apricots, papaya, and kiwi. For more information on the potassium blood pressure issue, go to DLife.com/potassium. I'm Lynn Prowitt for DLife TV. Thank you for watching.